Sigourney? 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 Sigourney, is that you? Girls are back, and Tony's got a- So today's video is going to be about baking a pie, and not just any pie, a bofa pie. Bofa what? Bofa these nuts. This was requested, I'm pretty sure, by Amina. It's been a few months since we talked about this, so if I totally remember wrong and it was actually one of you others, sorry. If it was anyone else who did it, then you'll take the credit. But thank you so much for suggesting that I make a pie. So really, I'm gonna start making a pie crust. The recipe just said to get a ready-made supermarket pie crust. I don't want to, because they are never good. Not here in Denmark, at least. I'm pretty sure that pie crusts are okay in the US. Maybe they're better there. But here in Denmark, you can't really get a ready-made pie crust that is worth eating. So I'm going to just make a pie crust, and because it's so easy. You literally only need usually three ingredients. For this one, I think it's a little more like four ingredients because it's a little special. So, flour, a little salt, and a glass of orange juice. No, this is one beaten egg with a little water in it. And the star of the show, super, super cold butter. I've put it in the freezer for a moment because it has to be as cold as possible. And now I have to work quick. I have my grater, my shredder? I don't know what they're called. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is shred the butter on the rough setting? Who knows? Do not shred the paper surrounding your butter. And do not shred your fingers either. So go slow right here, and the final piece goes right into the flour. Oh wow, what's this? Shredded cheese? No, it's butter. So now you quickly unite the butter with the flour and try not to get your warm hands on everything and melt it. You want to knead it together so it turns into like I don't know what you call the texture, because it shouldn't be clumpy. It should be like a sand, like a dry sand that still has some body to it? What am I saying? Someone in the comments, please figure out what I'm saying. Jenny, please help me. You could potentially do this in a food processor too, and it would go very quickly and work amazing. And I'm going to stop right around here and add the egg water mixture. Pull it all together into a cohesive dough. Plastic wrap. Always good for pie crusts. Cradle it like a little baby and cover and chop. Now this goes and rests in the fridge, and you have pie hands, so you want to open the fridge with your foot. Success! Now wash your hands. Time to make some filling. I want to chop the nuts up, which could take a while. Ooh, don't go. Don't leave me. Normally, I like to use a flat knife for this, but I only had this serrated knife. Otherwise, I would have to do some washing up, and I do not want to. So, I know a lot of people like using serrated knives for chocolate. And for nuts, I do not. I don't know who started this myth that it's better and easier to do with a serrated knife, because it is not. Exciting content, isn't it? And I have to do this for the walnuts too, so stay tuned for the sequel. Ah! My nuts! Don't comment on how I hold the knife. Just, you know, stay in your own lane. Walnut time. Gotta use some chocolate for later, because I'm going to make a ganache later. So I want to make some chocolate ganache. And to chop your chocolate effectively, you just take all your frustrations out on it. Ah, so many frustrations. I'm also going to use a little good chocolate. This was, you know, cheap chocolate. So I'm going to use a little extra, extra nice chocolate, which I am not going to take my frustrations out on. One thing you can do if you don't bash your chocolate first is stack it like this. And chocolate's all finely chopped up. I'm gonna put it over here in a bowl for later. And try not to get chocolatey hands. I'm gonna chop up some prunes, which is actually the most underrated fruit thing out there. People who don't like prunes, what's wrong with you? Are you okay? Prunes are great. They're nice. I don't understand the hate. So, I'm just pouring a little boiling water over them. Just enough to... Don't stick your fingers in the boiling water, by the way. I'm going to whisk up some eggs. 3 eggs. Whoa, is that a big yolk or what? Don't get any shells in there. And get the long ones out. Why does this happen? And I guess wash your hands again. Now for something fun for most people, not me. I don't drink, but I do drink through cooking and baking. So here I have some bourbon. Two shots of vodka. I have here normal white sugar and brown sugar, which is not in the recipe, but I love brown sugar and it tastes so good. How come it tastes so good? I don't know. I think it's gonna make it really syrupy and nice. Also, the recipe calls for corn syrup, which is a very American invention, and I don't have any. I do have some glucose, which I am very much considering putting in there, but I don't really want to. So I'm going to put some honey in, if I could find the opening there. This is gonna take a while. Come on. We don't have all day. Butter, we need butter. It says use melted butter. I don't want to. Just, you know, an amount of butter. Could be anything. And whisk together. So, I'm putting in my chopped nuts and my soft prunes. I'm going to fish them out real quick. Not get too much of the prune juice out. Just the bits. And mix it up. And now for the crust. We're going to go back to our crust because I think it's been enough time. It's had time to think and reflect and cool. And now we can roll it out. I want to try out a version of this where you don't have to use any flour and you don't actually have to have necessarily a clean work surface. So what I'm going to do is put down more cling film. Yeah! That was not good. Oh shit, dude, I'm bleeding. My little fingy. No. I put my finger into the little blade inside of this. Dude, at the worst time. This is gonna be a blood pie from now on. Dough's looking good. Now, I am gonna flour this, actually. Also, I'm pretty sure it hasn't been a full half hour, but no one's counting, so. Just, you know, put it everywhere. Do not inhale. Roll your pin over it a few times. Get it nice and floured. It's very flaky, so you gotta be careful. Wow, it is falling apart. Great. I'm not sure what I did wrong today. I mean, I don't think I've done anything wrong, but it is a tricky dough to work with. It's not supposed to stick to the pin like this. Whoopsie. The great thing about this dough is that you don't have to make it beautiful and even. You just have to make it work. It keeps breaking itself apart. What I want to do is kind of go like this. And now what? Delicately and femininely, you know, just, hey, that works. Voila! Pinch it so that it fits to the sides. I'm going to blind bake this. No, not like a Bird Box challenge blind bake it. I mean, like, I'm going to take some parchment paper and then I'm going to put some beans in. Open this one. Again? Are you kidding me? This fucking shit. Time and time again. Literally every single time. Why do they make that? I hate whoever designed this fuck shit. Calm down, Dee. Some people. Hold on, I think the parchment is a little too loud. Oh, and crucial step, you have to poke holes in the dough. Here, you can also take out your frustrations. There. Some people have professional blind baking beans made out of clay. I do not. I use either beans, chickpeas, steak burrito, lemon chicken,
vegetable.
I think this is fine. We can use these. But why is there a piece of crust in the container with chickpeas? Why is there an old piece of crust? A crusty piece of crust? Here. Who did this? Anyway, so... Oh, smells bad. Smells bad. Yeah, so really, you just want to weigh it down. And I think the oven is ready. So I'm gonna go over and put it in there. Go wash your hands again. While I wait for my crust to bake the first time, I was thinking I want to make a refreshing drink because I feel like it's going to be a long wait and I need something to do in between. So how about a lovely cucumber mixer? Let's see.
If you buy these in like a plastic wrap, you just have to peel the foreskin back. Oh, that's terrible. I know all our cutting boards look dirty, but I swear they're not. I swear we take them through the dishwasher every single time. They just look nasty because they've been used for many, many years. So now you take your frustrations out on this cucumber. Actually, do not joke about this. This is very dangerous, but fun. Snip, snip.
You know, keep chopping your cucumber. I'm pretty sure I'm not allowed to use this knife unless I'm under supervision by my dad. So I didn't ask him if I could borrow it. But I just went into the abattoir and got it myself, so. Extension cord. This beauty is a juicer, a slow juicer. You just go like this. Take your frustrations out. See how it turned a whole cucumber into a little bit of mesh and a lot of green juice. Can you see it? You can't see it. Hot. So hot. And a little bit of bubblies. That's the sound of the ice cube maker. And the oven. Beautiful. Schmuck. How can you not love that green? When people talk about that green, they mean money. I mean cucumber juice. Lovely. Fresh pie. At least, you know, the crust How do I get all these chickpeas out without hurting the crust? I guess I could pour them back into the Tupperware container. I'm just gonna do that. Now, it does look kinda doughy. I'm gonna put it in for just a moment and then see what happens. And then, don't fall apart. Do not fall apart. You do not fall apart. It's time for just a little break where I don't do anything except enjoy my drink. Jenny said the other day in the group chat she doesn't like cucumber juice. So, sorry, not sorry, Jenny. But this one's for you, King. Gee, it sure is boring around here. While I wait, I'm going to play a little more of my cover of Careless Whisper. So enjoy that. But I'm gonna just stare into the distance for a little while it plays. Take your hand. That's enough. Gonna go clean my butcher knife, I guess. Listen to how much this crust is sizzling right now. I'm gonna put it over here to cool. In the meanwhile, I could assemble my ganache for later. Oh my god, what is happening today? There's a wild cat outside, and it's been coming and going for months. I think almost a year now, at the very least. And it just, I saw it zoom past my crust, which is resting outside to cool, literally turning my back for 30 seconds, and there's a cat trying to eat my crust. Unbelievable. You better stop. For the ganache, you need two ingredients, which is cream and the chocolate we made earlier. So first of all, you take your frustrations out on the cream. Then, put it in the saucepan. The saucepan. Yeah. And put it over low heat. I mean, I'm pretty sure the cat didn't eat anything, but it looked like it was about to, and then it got spooked. So I'm really just waiting for the crust to cool down enough so I can put the filling in it. So I guess I can just, you know, wiggle this around a little bit. I do not have the patience for this. I'm just gonna get it. Because it's not sizzling hot. Like, I can touch it, and it's a little warm, and the crust is falling apart. Put your filling in. I thought I saw the cat again. I probably didn't. But, you know, you can never be too concerned. Time for bake number 3, I guess. I have somehow accumulated 3 tea towels on this counter, because I keep taking them and then leaving them here. I officially have nothing left to do except wait and heat up my cream for the ganache, and that's not very exciting. So I'm just gonna take it easy and then check in when the pie is done. See you then. Finally back, and we're losing daylight because it's literally been an hour and a half since I last left you, so I've waited for the full pie to cool off, and there's a good reason why recipes usually say that you need to wait 3 hours for a pie to cool off before eating it, because this is still definitely warm. I'm not touching it right now, but I'm hovering my hand over it. It's very much still warm. Also, it's buttery on the outside. Like, the walls are slippery. I don't know why. I've got my ganache over here. I hope it's good, because I accidentally sort of boiled the cream, which you're not supposed to do. But I'm pretty sure that you can't really mess it up. Tastes like chocolate, you know. I'm gonna spread this over the pie, and I'm not gonna wait for the pie to cool after, even though you should. I do not care anymore. I just want to eat this pie. This isn't an offset specialer. I guess it is, but it's an oversized office spatula that you would normally use to flip eggs or burgers. This one is for spreading out the ganache because I don't have a small one. It's hard to get a really clean surface, so I don't aim for perfection. That'll do, pig. That'll do. But before I cut into it, just take a look if I could pick it up because it's so greasy. A bofa pie for both of your nuts. I will say, look at how the crust is just coming off if you so much as speak about it. Like, it is very fragile. And actually something maybe I want to ask Jenny about next time I think about it. How do you, you know, work with pie crust in a way that makes sense, where it doesn't break off constantly and it's not impossible to handle? Because she does a lot of pie crust and she's really good at it. So I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I'm really just following the recipe. Jenny, help me. This is gonna be a terrible slice. Let's see how it tastes. Half of it fell off. Thanks. Thanks a lot. The flavor. The top note. Sweetener.
That's a 10.
This is pretty good. Not gonna lie. It's quite nice with a cup of tea. I just like the nuts. I do like them nuts. They're not crunchy. You know how they're... you know how nuts are kind of tender? And that's nice. I did my job well done, I think. So cheers. So that was very nice. Now what to do? Well, nothing really, except, you know, say hi and see you later.
Take your hand and lead you to the dance floor. As the music dies, something in your eyes calls to mind a silver screen and all it said goodbye. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm, though it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend. Waste a chance that I've been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I danced with you. Tonight the music seems so loud. I wish that we could lose this crowd. Maybe it's better this way. We hurt each other with the things we wanna say. We could've been so good together. We could've lived just dance forever, but no one's going to dance with me. Please stay, I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm, though it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. Should've known better than to cheat a friend. Waste the chance that I've been given. So I'm never gonna dance again the way I danced with you. So wrong that you had to leave me alone.